one who congratulates someone's death. I've never heard no disgusting shit like that in my motherfucking life. Never. But you have to be careful. Like I said, the tongue is a powerful motherfucker. And it really is. So be careful what you say. Be careful what you say on people.
Well, before I
return that same motherfucking favor.
Before somebody in the comments, I feel like it's going to be said. Somebody's going to say, well, they was just having a funeral for Miss Mitra not that long ago. Why all of a sudden now is the thing?
Miss Mitra ain't really dead. They was having a funeral for her mouth because she talked too much bullshit.
For her mouth and her character. Correct. And for no longer entertaining her bullshit. Because I could have been entertaining Miss Mitra bullshit because I've been seeing the stuff that she been saying in the comment section about me. But I chose not to. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't engage with the mentally ill. Okay?
And as far as Rosé, I've never seen Rosé jump in somebody live to jumping somebody live who jumping in. Rosé has her own shit going on. And that thing with her and Kev, you know, she feels how she felt about that. And how was she wrong for her opinion about, you know, something? A lot of people felt that way. I don't see nobody jumping down nobody else's throat about it. And I don't know who else he was talking about. You know, I can't.
Who else he was?
Who else it was, but the distastefulness in that shit. And you know what? I have to say to people, you know, when you follow people like that, you know, that gives off that demonic type shit, it rubs off on you.
That's true. Rosé do have a lot of positive lives. She really do. Now, will she check somebody? Yes, she will, for being disrespectful. Most definitely will.
But she really doesn't even do that, for real. Too often, she really don't do that. Because I think because she started on the other app, when she came over to TikTok, I think she wanted to kind of get away from that. Just from me being somebody who follows the garden, just the way she's kind of mentioned over there on the other app, it can get a little draining. So when she came to TikTok, she kind of wanted to show her other side. Like, yeah, she can read people, but she wanted to be on TikTok, like, showing her talents and stuff.
She ain't
just going after people. She's responding.
Yeah, that's different. And somebody was like, that man on the video rolled with the llamas. What they got to do with bad behavior? What they got to do with it? It's a bad fucking behavior. Period. It's not a good look. It's distasteful and disgusting to disrespect the dead. Let them people rest in peace. Your beef was your beef while they was here. Mm-hmm. These people have families. You know what I mean? Children, mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers. That's fucking insane. That's fucking insane to me. I'm baffled. It's fucking disgusting. It is what it is. It's disgusting and dis fucking tasteful. Child ain't gonna make my drink strong because this is not, that's fucking the child. Go ahead, Peach, because for my mouth beating.
They said Q came in here just to let y'all know. Stevie said Q entered the room just to let y'all
get
know.
Get your funky ass out of here, bitch.
He didn't comment, so I don't know how we're going to be able to catch whatever page he on. It's a lot.
Barb, I'm about to give you a ticket.
What's up, Stevie?
What I did, one rush. Girl, I'm just, girl.
I know, don't get me wrong. I'm playing, but, and I appreciate you
have the time to spend with your family, because that's much underappreciated these days. But baby, we needed you yesterday. Baby, the conversation went up, down, round, and round, drop it low to put it back up.
You talking about the day before yesterday, honey?
On Sunday.
Yeah, Sunday.
Either way, you could have directed the conversation. Even me and Classy was looking at each other. Classy's reaction was like, what is going on?
Yeah, okay, hold on one, Rush, because I don't know if you read the room. There ain't the time for that one right there. Hold on.
I'm a drive. I ain't trying to be disrespectful. I'm a drive. I'm just leaving.
It's a day today.
I'm so loud.
Yeah, it's okay, like, because she, it's okay, just. Yeah, y'all go ahead and change the subject, because I think the more I see him ponder on it, the more madder I get, you know. Feach, go ahead, like, flip, do what y'all do, you know.
Next topic, whatever that was, whatever was next.
Y'all trying to chew up my cookie.
You ain't talking about them little
what kind of cookie?
Pepperidge Farm.
Y'all be in my business.
I want to know what kind, so I can go buy me a box.
What do they call it? Jackson
Man. Yeah, Pepperidge.
Cheese Man.
And butter cookies.
Mm-hmm. Because she always merching on them. So I just feel like maybe we should all go get a box.
I ain't going to never unbeat my bag, baby.
They got to be good.
Yes.
I'm just saying.
Thank you, $2. So listen, for the ones that I have received you guys Amazon packages, content will be coming soon. Yeah, them the ones I'm eating the minis. But content will be coming soon, baby. I've been locked in. We're doing job applications and stuff like that, because I will be landing me a job by the end of the month. Mm-hmm. So during the day, I like to try to detach a little bit. I may jump in a room or two, but I may not stay long because I'm focusing on trying to secure that job by the end of the month. But anyways, content will be coming soon. Thanks to each and every person that has purchased something off of my Amazon wish list. It is greatly appreciated. And if you would like to purchase something off of my Amazon wish list, go to the link tree in my bio and click on my link tree and click on the Amazon wish list. Guys, let me tell y'all something. I truly, truly appreciate all of the love and support that you guys have been giving me during my transition. When I tell you God is amazing, God is amazing. So thank you guys so much for that. But anyways, baby, y'all ain't here for that. Y'all here for Toast of Tuesday. Listen, tap the screen, shut it live, baby. Tap the screen, shut it live.
Before you tussle, Piccadilly Yummy said, did you try Home Depot for work from home?
I did. Yes, I have. But stay tuned. Hopefully by the end of the week or by the beginning of next week, I will have some good news. So yeah, y'all just stay tuned. Hard work pays off. No day. All right, let's just go ahead and switch gears. Alexa, volume to max. Y'all tap the screen. Y'all annoying me right now for real, nigga. You want a top shelf sheet? You want to run your mouth? You want some change to start your motherfucking house? We are set this bitch out. Set this bitch out. We are set this bitch out. Set this bitch out. These niggas man rap. They call me bad ass. And I punish you. You ain't my equal. We ain't people. I ain't running. Since 98, I grab my... But the ones that are sending out a good job, leave. Can y'all send that over to resourcepeach@yahoo.com? I need to add it to my bio. We all got bread, so if we fall, we are crutches. We don't know when to do it. got to. Baby, we about to take a ride through these TikTok streets on the blog pages. Let's see what's been posted on the blog. Y'all already know what page we heading to first. We gonna head on over to Proxy page. Y'all already know it. Alexa, volume of 2. Y'all already know we heading over to Proxy. Matter of fact, let me load this one from the laptop so y'all can see the animations and stuff, because the animations is wild to me. Y'all tap the screen, please. You said it was kind of quiet today. Yeah, it probably was. I really wasn't on today, so yeah, I'm not sure. But you know, it's always quiet before the storm. Okay. So shouts out to Proxy. Let's see what we can see, honey. All right, so let's do. Okay, so this is Omega and Black Guru. Alexa, pause.
Really be happy to not even bring her up, because you made it seem as if she was stalking you. So if she was stalking you, brother, you would really be happy to not discuss her. You would really be happy to not even bring her up, because you said she was stalking you. So if she was stalking you, then the first thing you would want to do is leave her name out of shit. At the end of the day, bro, this not, you may not realize it, but you even make men upset with you, men who support you, because you're taking this too far. And it's cool. You can feel however you want. I see that you as a moderator from both the pages, whatever. I ain't gonna have nothing bad to say about you. But I'm gonna say this directly to you, bro. You doing too much. And you may think you're being in your own mind, but even men who support you are looking at you crazy right now, because it's not, this is out of character. This ain't even got nothing to do with Blazing. She's not even part of the narrative. She ain't even part of the storyline. She got nothing to do with this conversation at all. You're making her a part of this conversation because you're looking for an opportunity to drag this young woman. What I'm saying is, if what you said was true when this was the subject of conversation, you're making yourself look bad, because now it's looking like you're the one obsessed with her and not vice versa. But even, you don't know what we've privately spoken to her about since we found this out. But either way, bruh, this is not a good look. You can talk about me if you want. I'm not being disrespectful to you, but as a man, I'm gonna tell you, this is a contradiction to what you tried to make the point earlier. If she was obsessed with you, she was obsessed with you. But hey, now it's looking like the opposite. And I'm asking you to politely leave her name out your mouth, because this is crazy. Right,
y'all have said that multiple times. Let me respond. So here's the thing. This ain't about her. I said, this is about y'all and hypocrisy. And that's what we're not going to do. We're not going to be hypocrites. Okay? I don't rock with hypocrites. And the fact of the matter is that no matter if you knew back then, didn't know, and you know now, you know. Now you know. And at the end of the day, I'm a man just like you. If you had a problem with anything that was going on with me, then you should have me as a man. Don't come now and say, I don't even agree with all you're talking about. Y'all literally will go to somebody that y'all claim to be an enemy to give gossip and tea to the same women that can't stand y'all.
Peter was at my house, at my rental property.
So that's the first one. This is the second one.
What's going on with this? Men don't move like that.
Guru.
Y'all can't, if y'all can't, hold on. I'm speaking.
Hey, like I said, we're listening. Keep our sister's name out your mouth. We're not joking with you.
I'm speaking.
No, we don't care about what you're saying. We're not joking.
Man, God damn it. Stop this shit, bro.
It's a lot of stuff to talk on the internet. But anyway, as I was speaking.
Stop! Y'all got me yelling on a Monday! Christ!
Yeah, I got a flight to catch, so I got to go real soon, so I'm not going to be long. Only thing I'm saying is that what we're not going to do, because I don't rock with individuals like this, and I just clap back about it. What we're not going to do is deal with the ops and then play in my face or play in another man's face and act like you cool with them too. If you with the ops, then you with the ops. If y'all ride with Tea Time and the rest of them course, over there in the gossip channels, and that's the first y'all run to expose stuff, then cool, then stay over there. Don't come back. Don't lurk on my platform. Don't visit my platform. And I ain't got nothing to say after that.
All right, Brother Saw.
That was the perfect way to end it. And the reason why I come over there is the troll. That's it every time. Fuck with the people on your panel. That's the only reason why I come over there. And you know it.
I'm going to pause this. Dick. What's up, Chasing Pillows? How you doing, baby? Chasing Pillows.
I'm so sorry. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I can hear you now. What's up, baby? How you doing?
I'm doing okay. I heard you guys were playing the video a little earlier with King of Hearts. I was on my page, I guess.
Oh, yes. Yes, ma'am. We were playing it.
Okay. Do you mind if I just explain to you the situation a little bit? I know you guys are talking about some other shit right now.
Would you like for me to run the video again for people to get a gist of what you're going to be talking about?
Yeah, come on. Yeah, that would be perfect.
Okay, no problem. Hold on. Let me fix my screen and stuff, sweetie. Give me a second. Y'all tap the screen, please. All right, give me a second, guys. Y'all tap the screen, please. All right, here we go. So this video is from Chasing Pillows. One second.
Take the cooked eggs in the hail. How long does it take to cook a pot roast in the hail? You would never have another cold drink a day in your life. Okay. Yeah, she kicked that bucket harder than the mother. She kicked it too hard. She kicked it so hard she lost her life. You should have kicked that damn bucket that hard. At least when I kicked the bucket, I barely kicked the bitch. I wound up behind you for like 4 days, but you kicked that bitch a little bit too goddamn hard. YSB, you need to start kicking that bucket, man, with your eternally illness ass. Blaze, you been kicked the bucket, man. Look at your teeth. You got 14 teeth. You know what I'm saying? You're a recovering crackhead who's right back on crack again. Police, you're out here talking shit. You bald head as hell. No motherfucking hell. Ain't got the nerve to talk about somebody need to massage your scalp. Bitch, nobody need to massage nothing. Don't sit down somewhere, man. Y'all are losers. Y'all ain't got nothing. Y'all talking about we over here begging for money. When have you ever heard me ask for anything? Bitch, I don't ask for a like. I don't ask for a follow. I don't ask somebody to tap the screen. I don't ask for nothing. Because I'm a real man. If I ain't got it, I'm going to get it. What up, Tasha? If I ain't got it, I'm going to get it. And if I can't get it, that means I ain't need it bad enough. I've been working since I was 18. I've been in the street since I was 12. I done did my time, sorry. Matter of fact, when I went to prison, I did my time and your time. And many times I done been locked up, bitch, I done did my time and your time. I'm tired of you drunk, bitch, you coming on this app, getting intoxicated, and then talking shit about people. And then when somebody say something to y'all, y'all blame it on the alcohol. It's a drunk person speaks sober thoughts, right? So you ain't doing nothing but trying to tell your truth. Or what you think is the motherfucking truth. Deputy, I ain't forget about you, bitch. I ain't forget that you had an attack me over there in Tasha Live. I roasted your ass about that. You ain't say nothing else to me. Cause you know, Shada, I'm the type, I'll push you over the edge. I'll push you to a limit that you would not come by. Cause like you don't give a fuck about me, I don't give a fuck about you either. Chasing Chico sticks. Really? So you wanna sit here, you wanna pull up people mug shots? You pull a shiny blaze mug shots. You say, you know what I'm saying, Rosiana don't want no parts of you. You think you some big bad wolf, no bitch, just big. Ain't nothing bad about you except for your body weight. So maybe you is a big bad wolf. That's, yeah, maybe you is, well, damn. You got the right name. You got the right name, Chasing Beef Stew. You got the perfect name. Chasing. Pillow, no, man. Go sit your ass down somewhere, man. I told you before, Shot, if you had an issue with me, to be an adult, to be a woman, that's up to me. Can't nobody tell you shit about my bad because they wasn't up. They didn't live my life. I did. I'm the only one that can answer those questions. And if I feel like giving you an answer, I give it to you. A lot of y'all know what I'm saying, like to make up these make-believe stories about people. And then when they call y'all ass out, y'all want to play victim. Like I told y'all, the little bitch, Rosé. Ever since Rosé been on this motherfucker app, people ain't watching, you know what I'm saying, her moves. Like they supposed to be watching their moves. They thinking she's a cool person. But really, watch how she jump at people panel. And talk shit. As soon as that live ends, she'll go live her damn self and start talking shit about that person. Notice how she went out to kill the comment when they decided to put this group together. To change TikTok for, you know what I'm saying, for to better us as people. How she got jealous. She was wondering why she wasn't part of the team. And all the care people was telling her, Shawty, we don't know you. We don't know you. That's your best answer right now. So what you decided to do? You decided to take care of. I thought that was kind of crazy. And then you sat there and said that he'll be disrespectful towards you. We listened to that live. To take the cook eggs in the hell. How long does it take to cook a pot roast in the hell? You would never have another cold drink a day in your life. Yeah, she kicked that bucket harder than
so, that's the video. Go ahead, check it out.
So, I mean, I'm really not, like, to be honest with you, I really don't know why he has a direct problem with me. It seems like the only person that, like, is closely related to him is Shani. And that's the girl that I've been talking about that some people have messaged me on the back end when I was speaking about her, telling me that they did not get resin trays. And I had a personal problem with her. So I'm speaking about it on my live, on my platform. And I guess that's what had pissed him off to where he felt like going off on a rant or some type of tantrum. I'm really not sure, even when I went live, because I did address him last night.
I didn't drag him. You know, I didn't say his full name. Today, this man was on Bego saying my full name, pretty much doxing me on Bego. And the only reason that he has my information is because one of his white tea people, Mariah, I was cool with her at one point, long time ago. So he went live on Bego today because I didn't see the live. I was shown a screenshot. She apparently sent him some text messages. I don't have text messages with her anymore because we haven't been friends over a year. And I deleted them like any normal person would delete old messages over a year old. So anyways, but he was on Bego, he was doxing me. The man is upset because I brought up Shawnee Blaze. I brought up the fact that she has child abuse charges. I'm sorry, trigger warning. You understand? I talked about her. I did. She came up from one of the people mentioning her, talking about her. Somebody else named Rostiana. It's a beef that's so old in time, it doesn't make sense. But I felt like talking about it. But today, this man was still, he said, he pretty much went over me, Rosé, and Tripp, pretty much called Tripp a transvestite. He said Rosé calls herself Rosé because her coochie probably smells like woo woo woo. Her coochie probably stank. Then he called me chasing every food item in his kitchen. He called me chasing donuts, chasing chicken wings, chasing chitlins, chasing whatever the fuck he said. And I was just like, yo, I was not talking about, I did not say this man's name. I have not said this man's name, and I have not been talking about him. So for him to have so much smoke for me, it is now day two, where after he said that I am nothing, along with Rosé and Tripp, he went over to Bego, got more information from a YT woman I was friends with over a year ago on the app. Put my name out, show whatever text. I wish I had the text, because if I had the text, I could go through it. I could validate if it's true or not. I can. So over a year ago, we talking about a private conversation. I've never directly said anything to or about this man at all. Have I had private conversations with my friend? Yes. But everything that me and my friend at the time, you know, just like you, Peach, you might talk to people off the app, you know, about whatever that happens on the app. And that's y'all's private conversation. That's literally the same shit. She didn't bring it up at the time the conversation happened. She bring it up. She brought it up to put two black people against each other, which is what's happening right now.
But why?
Because she got upset because I was addressing her a long time ago. I was addressing her. So she felt like, okay, well, you know, she didn't want to stand on her own. She didn't want to address me on her live. She didn't want to come up in a box when I was in a box on somebody else's page. She said, let me go to the closest black person that she was talking about, that she said something about why is he in a panel if he has domestic violence and child abuse charges? Why is he in a panel while the information came to the internet? Why is he in a panel as we're discussing shit that could be triggering to some victims, to some survivors? That was my concern. She never disagreed with me either, Peach. This bitch agreed. Everything she's trying to show or talk about is shit that we as friends talked about. So now she's trying to build some shit. He's coming at me full force. Like, you would think I'm on here talking about him on a daily. I haven't said this man's name, Peach.
Right. So listen, let me say this. So let me read this comment real quick. Only One said, you can't talk or text anymore. Only face to face and leave your phone at the door. Honey, it's ridiculous. Yes. Like, you can't even have like a genuine private conversation with people anymore. Right. Because people be wanting to bring stuff to the forefront and try to, so to say, you know what I'm saying? Try to paint a negative narrative about you. And it's sad that you actually have to protect yourself like that, though.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's so many people out here that lie. But go ahead.
Mm-hmm. I might have. And I already admitted to it. I admitted when I came on, when I was talking shit about her and I called her like a trashy ass parent, I could understand she felt some type of way. But you got all these other people involved. And it just proves my whole point of what I was speaking about when I went live. Pretty much, I'm saying, like, if I have a problem with you, Peach, I'm not going to go to Barb's. I'm not going to go to Kel's. I'm going to go to you. You understand? I'm not going to, if you
have a problem with me. You know what I noticed on this app? A lot of people are not very direct. They're not. They're used to throwing rocks behind their hands to the point where when you are a very direct person, they try to make you out to be problematic.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It made him feel that uncomfortable. He got upset about the whole, he mentioned, you know, me talking about Mrs. Nietzsche's mod, the Mario situation. He got upset about that. He's like, why are you bringing up people's past? It's obvious you don't change, because why does it seem like your target is just women? Period. Like, he went off on a rant about women, about four women, including myself. And then went off again today. Like, nobody was going to hear about it. Like, it's just weird. Like...
That live was from today? I mean, that recording was from today?
Oh, that recording was from either Saturday or Sunday, but he went live again about it today.
I know you explained it. You may know, you may not. What was his purpose of speaking on Blue Dove and, you know, with her transition? What was that about?
So, to my knowledge, so there's... Yo, it's an old ass beef for like 2 years. Blue Dove, rest in peace, Blue Dove. She was on like the Blaze side of TikTok, and Kappa, the Llamas, they have an issue. They have direct beef with Blaze and them people over there. So Blue Dove, she was one of Blaze's supporters. So, you know, she probably said some crazy shit in the comments at one point. I don't know specifically what that lady did say, but I do know when somebody passes away, to keep shit going, it seems a little foul to me to keep it alive. And what the lady's not here no more to say anything. What are we really doing? What is the purpose? Like,
that shit was disgusting and distasteful in itself. Like, I mean, the rest of the people are here, you know, including yourself, are here to defend for yourself. I just, that was weird to me. That's weird.
Very weird. And the fact that he was like, come to him as a woman, like, stand up to him as a woman. Like, what the hell? And he's a man. That's just weird.
Like, I don't get that. I didn't get that whole scenario. Comes to me as a woman. I don't get it. Like, what are you, woman to woman? Like, what are we talking?
Like, he wanted me to, like, when I had a conversation with my friend about my concern about his abuse charges, his violent past coming up, because that came up, and I'm talking to my friend, and she brought that to you, apparently I should have just stepped to him if I had a concern. Why would I do that if I don't feel comfortable with you in spaces that I'm in, that you weren't in initially? He was kind of new, because he was not initially, he didn't start off like when Kappa started the Llamas, he wasn't always there. He was just somebody that just started being there. And I was just asking, like, why, if all this shit came out, like, why is it okay for him to be in spaces like this as we're talking about domestic violence and all this other shit? Like, I don't know. I just thought it was weird. And my friend at the time agreed with me. She never said nothing before until we got into a problem, which is months later. Months later. So now this man is on Bigo doxing my name. Because that's as much as she knows about me, for real.
I'm confused. It said we're made for someone still living. Ooh. Oh, man, get the fuck up. Listen, we already explained it. See, y'all. I got a headache, and sometimes...
That's a troll page. Don't pay that no mind.
Like, go on. Find somebody else to play with. Not today. Not...
Well, I appreciate you, Peach. I appreciate you for playing this, because I already know this is... It's going to drag, because, I mean, trash is going to be trash. If you're a trash person, you're going to continue to be trash. So it's just going to keep on dragging. But everything I talk about, I bring awareness to shit, and that is it. I'm going to keep on bringing awareness and keep pissing people off. So, I mean, it is what it is. It is what it is. All I can do.
I mean, that's true.
appreciate you.
Yeah, I mean, you're going to come up against different oppositions and things like that. You know what I'm saying? As long as you know you're doing it for the greater good, you know what I'm saying? I would say, you know what I'm saying? Keep doing what you're doing and, you know what I'm saying? Stay protected.
Thanks, bitch. I appreciate y'all. Thank y'all, ladies. I'm a drug. I appreciate y'all. Though.
Thank you so much for coming up.
Yeah. Yeah.
You study ask you asking her what was his purpose of speaking on the deceased. That's a good question for him, because when nobody know his thought process but him.
You right. You are absolutely right. But I sometimes people may know the backstory. Why, you know, I don't know. It's different type of people raised in these days. And then to address the ankle biter in the comment. Yes, obituary was made for a living, but it wasn't an obituary. I don't know where you been or when last time you been to a funeral. They don't make them like that no more. And again, it was not to unalive someone. It was to unalive their mouth and their character. I don't know how long it's going to take y'all to get there. You know, you keep bringing that shit up like you saying something, like you getting pointers. You ain't getting shit. Right. Nothing.
I refuse to keep going back and forth with the mental ill. Not finna keep doing that. Something wrong with that lady.
So because we don't want to hear duck mouth ass bitch keep rambling. That's good. So what I advise your aunt eat head ass to do is keep it motherfucking moving, bitch.
Right. Cause you know, I've been seeing what Sour Neck been saying about me in these comment sections.
But they over here. Ain't now bitch jumped in that live and told her how to get that stink ass sour ass neck corrected. But you over here asking motherfucking questions.
Y'all told that ask Miss Nitra why she making excuses and talking about people chopping up and editing a video. How the fuck you gonna get on camera and actually say out your mouth that I said it, but I just didn't say it in that order? Bitch, it's the principle that you fucking said it. Stupid.
And I do you one better. You ain't even got to ask the bitch. Just go tell the bitch. Soap and water. Cleanse the sour and the stankness of your neck. Bitch, if you stop pushing the hair to the front, bitch. And trying to hide that big long ass forehead, the sweat went trickle down the back of your head, bitch, to your neck, and that's how it get dark, stinking, stupid.
Miss, you better sit down somewhere before I start playing the audios.
And I promise you, bitches, this is not what y'all want today. So what you could do, bitch? Get the fuck from over here asking me questions and go help that hoe clean that feces from around her motherfucking neck. That what the word is, asbestos, bitch. Get the fuck over there and help her with that, bitch, and get the fuck from over here. The fuck wrong with you?
You know, alcohol is in her pores. Most definitely, she probably walk around smelling like a fucking liquor barrel.
Alcohol and dirt, because as long as that shit sit around her neck, bitch, is unhealthy. It's like gingivitis, bitch. At some point, you got to clean it. That shit backs up. It smells. It comes infected.
Thank you, 803, for the gifts. I appreciate it. Y'all, can y'all help me reach my live goal, please?
Thank y'all for the gifts. Sorry I ain't type y'all, because I'm just in a fucked up mood. And I hate when, just leave me the fuck alone today, bitch. So look, Aunt Edith, take your crawling ass back over there, bitch, to the ant farm with that fuck shit. Cause today is not the day. Bitch, I will cuff you out so motherfucking softly, bitch. You and your ancestors would have never heard of this shit. Don't you understand? So while you trying to, while she's trying to continue to the draw Underground Railroad track in her motherfucking neck, bitch, jump on the train and follow it, pussy asshole.
Alright, let's play this. Let's play this video. Is this you, Miss Nitra? Thank you for the cash up. I appreciate it. Thank you, baby. So, Miss Nitra, is this you?
I was part of the child. This is good to me, y'all. They be running Miss Nitra down, y'all. Let me tell y'all something. They spreading a bunch of lies on Miss Nitra, but I ain't got time to catch up with all of them. I don't give a, like, can I say this respectfully and y'all still follow me tomorrow when I come home? I don't give a shit. I don't care. I don't give a shit. If they tell you I was part of the whatever. Whatever I was, if they said they saw me running down the highway butt ass naked and nobody picked me up, I was. Whatever they told you, period. I'm not finna chase it. I don't give a shit about it. It is what it is. They're gonna record me. They're gonna chop up. I saw a video tonight of me where I know what I said and they chopped it up and put together. They put this after this. I said it, but it was all at different times.
Girl, shut your ass up, lying.
That don't even make sense.
They gonna chop up. I saw a video tonight of me where I know what I said and they chopped it up and put together. They put this after this. I said it, but it was all at different times. Girl, let these people that want to be bloggers and they freaking haters do what they do. Period, Po. This is good to me.
They can't be the...
Here,
stopping
Miss Nature. Thank
go
you.
Go ahead,
love.
Go ahead. I can't be the people that came on the app and was holding Bible study. You can't convince me this the same woman.
She was Bible study.
You know
that's
what I'm
about to say.
You know what I found is weird.
Everybody, you know them fake Bible thumpers.
You know what I found weird? Soap is good to me, but people refuse to use it.
Baby, ain't nothing like that hot water coming up out of that shower, steaming up that bathroom.
I'm just
ain't nothing like that water hitting that skin. And you washing up real nice, get some good lathers on you.
I've never seen
it rinse your body off.
Right,
you do that a couple times. Make sure you get the bottom of your feet, bitch.
But she used to hold Bible study.
Cause some people don't wash the bottom of their feet because they think just because it touched the tub, it's clean. No, you gotta wash your feet.
Put soap on it, bitch. You know it's weird to me. Everything is good to her. Everything. This is good to me. That is good to me. That is good to me. But the smelling of the sour neck is good to you. Also,
well, she might be blind. You know, after a while, your body just get used to it.
So if
that's nasty. That's
she
nasty.
Don't know.
If she
that's nasty.
Smell that mean her house smell like that.
So that could be why.
Why her nose rinse it like that?
Right there though, she actually
or maybe
she
cute.
Maybe she had long.
Don't lie like that.
Maybe she had long Rona.
She didn't look bad right there.
Her nose
does
look bad. Who would with their hair like that?
The reason for me showing y'all this is because I was made aware that the pushback is genetically in a family. So the one with the black hair is not even her. So everybody in the family is a pushback.
So alopecia over there.
Yeah, they like to have mohawks in their family.
Oh.
I mean, well,
that's tension alopecia from them braids. You got to lay off them braids and let your edges grow back in.
But ain't traction alopecia more like the hair start kind of fading? It looked like that's completely bald to the
that top. Look like alopecia.
She got a
it looks like the motherfuckers glued on piece by piece. Jesus, fix it.
Yeah, my conclusion is that she got a newborn head, and I hate that for her.
For sure, they definitely so keen because all these bitches pushing their hair to the front. Except this dumb bitch with them damn parking spaces on the side.
You showed us now.
Not the landing strip.
I'm talking about this bitch trying to get Air Force One in get it to the White House. Space for the. It behooves me the way these bitches. You know what, Barb?
Gotta keep your page.
No, I got the fuck off that bitch. I ain't stupid.
Oh, you saved. Okay, good job.
What's up, all my big booty bitches?
See, now you got
Is somebody is looking for me? I'm sorry.
Mom said you left her out.
Yeah, you left me out.
No, Barb, you still post the answer to it. Manifest.
You still got
to,
like,
when I say big booties, you got to, like, say you got it so that way you got
it's
it.
My
like,
it's my faith.
It'll come out.
It's my faith.
I love doing the squats, Barb. That's all.
Faith of talk, because I ain't doing no squats. The only way I'm getting that ass up
It's gonna be by faith whether you get on the table or do some squats.
It's gonna be
your head bald because everybody's right to bald.
I am love. Honey,
you know what you do got, Bob? You got a head full of hair.
Shit.
A lot of your head. You got that. And you got the face card, okay?
You got face card and you got titties.
Y'all lied. Remember, I look like Macca Blackson.
Nobody said
they
you stupid motherfucker. You stupid motherfucker.
You never gonna let that go.
No. Cause I can't let it go. Cause how long we live by that? You still laughing about it? Well, I can't let it go because people in the house still laughing about it.
Well, I never thought it was funny because you don't look like Michael Blackston.
At all.
You know what? It will be an honor to look like him because he is a very unique motherfucker. And he's funny in his own way. And I would love to have his bank account.
Me too. Did y'all see that video where they said that Michael Blackston is not even really from Africa, that he's actually from the US? And then he fakes his accent.
He probably just got strong descendants. Like, he probably, you know, how they be coming over here.
His face is just grown.
Yeah, you know how they be coming over here as a child and grow up in America. Or his parents come over here. And then
he's from the U.S. How he gonna be the first generation?
Like, his parents came over here before they had him, and then they had him in America. So he's American.
I don't know. Honestly, I didn't go that deep into it, but I bet y'all figured out.
Because his accent is so good. He got to be around Africans on the regular.
My accent is also very good. My accent is good as well. If you would have thought that I came from over there, but I really did not. I was born over here in the U.S., but people would not know that if I talk like this. They would think I'm from over there.
Thank you.
You can't hide that Texas if you wanted to.
It's a little country mixture in that, baby. I can't.
That is because my ancestors came over here.
And they moved to Texas.
Hello. That is what's happening.
That's your story, and we sticking to it.
Sticking to that story.
But yeah, I mean, it is what it is. But don't come over here doing all that other shit about no damn Miss Nitra. Miss Nitra, this, like, when I first came on this app, Miss Nitra was one that I liked it because I thought she was a genuine person. But over time, I've seen that Miss Nitra ain't what she said she was. And I don't know if that's because
ain't shit.
Miss Nietzsche going through something. I don't know what
when happened. Did she transition from Bible study leader until messy ass elder?
Wait, when did she do when did she do Bible study? She really did Bible study?
Yeah, I'd never been there for the Bible study.
Yeah, I heard something about, or maybe not Bible study specifically, but she would have like faith-based type of content. Like that's the type of like Christian type stuff, basically.
Well, you can only pretend to be a sheep for so long till the
wolf. You mean, yeah. But so was she on Christian talk first and then she transitioned over to messy TikTok?
If she was on,
that's Christian what I'm wondering, because how do you change? That's two different ends of the spectrum.
But if she be on Christian talk, then let her be on Christian talk, because half of the motherfuckers on Christian talk, our faith stronger than theirs. And we on messy TikTok. That says a lot.
That says
a lot.
That is true. That is very true.
Let her stay over there.
It gotta
she
be somebody
not over her. She over her.
Let me tell you, my daddy just sold his gospel record label because he was tired of dealing with them folks, and he kept the urban label. So that should tell you a lot.
The ones in the church be the biggest heathens.
And the most criticizing people I ever seen in my life. You know, you will think they God, how judgmental they are, you know. But we ain't gonna get into that, because I could tell you some shit, but I ain't. But just know for yourself that God comes for a church with no spot, no wrinkle, and that church is within you. You do what you need to do. You do your own relationship with God. But we're going to keep moving, because I hate to bring God up when I'm drinking and talking shit, because I know I'm going to cuss a bitch out.
But like, real fast,
I'm going to
just say this, and then the Christian church talk. So when people come like that, they judge me for all that. They not no Christians, because that's not the definition of a Christian. They just churchy. That's a huge difference. Like, so you coming and you being judgmental and you doing all this extra crap like that, and you speaking down on people because they don't live the life that you live or whatever the case may be, you ain't a Christian. You just churchy. And you gonna bust hell wide open just like everybody else if you don't get it together. So that ain't no true definition of a Christian. You just churchy for no reason. And I'm just leaving it at that.
Y'all, Lisa, let me tell y'all something.
Don't do it, please. Don't you do it. Do not take this to church. I just tried to get the fuck
out. No, you know, I'm going to tell you something. Listen. So today, I had a really good day. My day was really good, y'all. I cooked my dinner. Y'all know I like to start my dinner kind of early in the day or whatever, so it'll be done by the time my kids get home from school. So today I cooked me some lima beans with the smoked turkey necks, slow cooked them. Some white rice, some cream of chicken, some baked cream of chicken. You know how you let the chicken slow cook? Put your cream of chicken on it, you know, put your little Lipton onion soup mix in there with the bell peppers and onions with some cornbread. Y'all tell me why my daughter don't want to clean the kitchen. And she did a great job with cleaning the kitchen. I mean, the kitchen is spotless. It's clean just like I would. She don't put all the food up, put it in the refrigerator. But she pulled all of my gravy off of my chicken.
What's the gravy?
As she should. I don't like gravy, so.
She poured the gravy in the sink.
It's the cream of chicken gravy, though, J to the L. It's not like brown gravy.
No, it's not brown gravy. It's the cream of chicken soup gravy. You know how your meat marinate? And you put the cream of chicken in there and let it bake, and all the goodness and all the flavor is right there in the chicken and the gravy. So you really ain't got to put no salt or nothing on your rice. Only thing you got to do is put a little butter.
Little gravy. Uh-huh.
Yeah, the gravy supposed to hit that rice.
Yes. Where's the gravy?
Yeah, she put the chicken away and pulled the gravy off the chicken.
Where's the gravy? Did she pour it in the sipping bowl?
So the chicken dried in the motherfucker.
She pulled it down the garbage disposal.
Jesus, fix it. The baby didn't know.
Well, in her defense, she thought it was liquid that would take away.
She didn't know. She didn't know. Oh, bless her.
I have not had hot water cornbread in years. Nah. You know, hot water cornbread was that shit.
Honey, it was. Baby, especially if your mama know how to get in there with that cast iron skillet and pour that little lard up in there and fry them bad boys. Baby, I could just eat them by itself.
Okay, yeah, I'm glad we're talking about food because... Somebody please tell me how the fuck do you fucking fry chicken legs? Cause I deep fry mine. I can't win. It's like I tried to fry them and it just like it gonna burn before the inside get done.
Hold on, what type of stove you cooking on? A gas stove or electric?
Electric.
Okay, so you don't never want to fry anything that you fry, you don't never want to fry it on high.
Fry low?
You fry it low and slow. Yes, low and slow. You allow your grease to get up to a certain temperature, and you fry it low and slow.
Get a deep fry because when it comes to legs could be tricky, and put it on a certain temperature and let it go. Don't just because you got a deep fry, everything don't mean go high. Yeah. Put that some bitch on a good temperature and you'll be surprised how them legs come. Because if you put it on high, it's gonna look dumb. As soon as you poke that faucet in, blood gonna come out there.
Blood everywhere.
Yeah, I ain't had nobody to ask. I appreciate y'all. Y'all know I'm still a young tenderoni, and I'm still learning how to fry legs. I can fry every damn thing else, but these legs just be whooping my ass.
Yeah, I learned that the hard way. Like I've learned that from fucking up, because I used to always cut my deep fryer on high, because you know you could cook little wingettes, you know, little wingettes on high. Yeah. And they good, they done, but them big ass pieces, like when it comes to thighs and legs, you gotta turn that hole down and let them holes cook. Yeah, you do deep fry because you want it to be over with, but bitch, that shit like slow loving. You gotta let that grease make look.
Bro, for some reason your phone sound like it's not sounding clear.
Oh shit!
Who Bart?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Okay, you sound better now. You sound better now.
Oh, then my little pinky was making her way over it again. My pinky's been a problem all my life. It's normal now. Don't you go looking at for my hands. I'll show them to you when I get my nails done. Cause I know how you hoes is. You hoes missing. Barb missing a pinky. That'll be the next shit. Them hoes will stay.
Look, Barb got a pinky.
They're gonna call you Nubby.
Nubby Barbie.
Nubby Barbie. Hey, Nina. Nina said she can't tell who talking. Oh, yeah. Sometimes they do that sometimes, honey.
Hey Nina, how you doing? You see my light? You see my box? See my light?
No, I don't think once you can't see it, you can't see it.
You go. Yeah, it's gonna take a minute to.
Hey Nina. I think my box. Yeah, my box just lit up.
Y'all, why does it seem like it's so late?
It's a cloudy day over TikTok, though. You know what I mean? I feel like that should be for anybody, not to bring this conversation up. It's a cloudy day over TikTok. Everyone should feel like that. But one thing we gonna do, we gonna tussle Tuesday, because one thing Blue Dove did love was tussle motherfucking Tuesday. So y'all hoes bring y'all shit to the panel.
Hold on, wait. Do you see what Bone Production say about
this? I said pinky in the brain.
Pinky in the brain, Barbie Peach. So who the fuck ain't got no brain?
Oh,
Who is it?
They talk about got no brain.
No, they talk about the Barb pinky is the pinky girl. And
you the brain.
So show you the pinky, cause her, we talk about her pinky finger being nubby.
Yeah,
the
pinky
finger. Yeah. Pinky and the brain. One of them motherfuckers was dumb.
Pinky was the dumb.
Pinky was dumb, but you get what they saying. I get it. I ain't mad at it. I don't give a fuck, cause
they talk about pinky.
Peach was funny. I ain't even mad. Peach, listen, for Blue Dove, bring your shit to the goddamn panel. You hoes argue for good time's sake. For my good girl, Blue Dove. Who got problems out in these streets?
Y'all want to toast of the day. They must have was too messy yesterday, so now everybody in their perspective corners ain't bothering nobody.
Yeah, because you know somebody can hang out up there.
Before we toast, can I ask somebody a question? I keep going to the motherfucker store buying motherfucking green and red peppers, right? And I guess I'm not using them in a timely manner, but when I go to other people's house, they shit sitting there fresh and good. What am I supposed to do?
Where are you buying your produce from? If it ain't from Publix?
I got
Kroger.
No, don't shop at Kroger for produce.
Mm-mm. No, not Kroger. Well, hell, I live in Mississippi. We ain't got Publix.
I got a different opinion. If your food is not getting old, that's a problem. So that means your food is good that is getting old. It's healthy. It's real. The stuff that lasts too long, that's the shit that ain't healthy for you.
I don't know about that, Junior Mom, because
literally,
I started a garden last year, and I had some green peppers that I grew that actually lasted probably a good 2 to 3 weeks on the counter. And the ones from the grocery store was bad. And I only grow organic.
Yeah, so, they put pesticides on these foods in the grocery store.
Yeah, I used to put them in the refrigerator. So I said, okay, this time I'm not going to put it in the refrigerator. So maybe they'll last. The bitch weaseling now. That bitch then turned from green. The bitch got a little orange cut. The bitch got a little spot. I said, I don't understand how people keep their vegetables long lasting.
Well, put it in a mason jar. Like, mason jars will keep your stuff fresh. Like, if you're not ready to use something like fruits and vegetables and stuff, put it in a mason jar.
But don't you gotta have that pressure cooker shit for it to stay that way? Because I would think that would get moldy just sitting in a mason
jar.
You
talking about like those Ziploc bags that seal them in,
actual mason jar where they used to use for moonshine back in the day.
Yeah, just get your mason jar. I know, that's right, class. I'm going to drink this on.
I think with the mason jars, though, I think only like certain produce lasts longer in mason jars.
Yeah, but you have to vacuum seal the mason jar in order for it to. And some things, especially when they have a lot of water in them, you have to put a paper towel in there too to kind of soak up some of the moisture. But yeah. Barb, the reason why your green pepper is starting to turn colors is because green peppers are premature peppers. When they're like red and orange is when they're more mature.
Oh,
so they turn green first, and then they turn another color.
I'm gonna stop buying them
outright. I'm just gonna buy them the day I need them, man, because I don't have a green thumb. Clearly, I don't think all these bitches turn the color around this motherfucker.
Another thing.
I'm finna mute. I gotta let some of this look out.
You know what? Her and her pee-pee, but another thing you could do too is just cut them up fresh after you've washed them and just dry them and freeze them.
Yeah. That make a lot of sense though, because the red and yellow peppers last a little bit longer than the green peppers.
Okay. Well, I don't know, y'all. I'm the type, if I ain't finna use it, I ain't finna buy it. I normally buy like fresh produce when I need it, so that way I ain't just letting stuff go to waste, because I'm real bad about putting stuff in the refrigerator and forgetting I got it in there.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Right.
I buy fresh produce, like you said, when I'm getting ready to cook. Like, if I'm cooking it within that week, I'm going to buy fresh produce. But if I know it's going to be in there for maybe like a week or two, maybe three, I'm going to buy some freezer food. But I try to go like the healthy, still go the healthier route when it comes to even with that.
They say I add peppers to everything. I know that's right too. Me too. Mm-hmm. I'm really not even supposed to have certain peppers, because of my blood type, but whatever.
What kind of blood type you got?
I'm an A positive blood type. So I'm really, it's certain peppers that I can't, that I'm not supposed to have. And like, I'm really supposed to be vegetarian.
Oh.
Thank you for the gifts, y'all. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
I'm with you when you're right, Nita. It got to be in my eyesight, because, baby, I'm going to let it go. Like, if I go and make some tacos and y'all know how y'all get that, like the shredded lettuce. Mm-hmm. And I use it all and I put it back in the refrigerator. Oh, it's gone, gone. It's just gone, baby. Don't even worry about it. Throw it away.
Yeah.
It'll be brown by tomorrow anyway. That lettuce don't last no time when you open it.
That's true, yeah.
All right, y'all. Here we do the Toxic Tuesday. Anybody got some beef? Lettuce, tomatoes. Cucumbers. Anybody got anything? And cilantro. Yeah, do y'all got any of that? All right, that's a good job.
Ground beef.
Lamb chops.
Ground chuck. Whatever you want to call it.
Yeah, I want some hood nacho now too. Rob, you say you got beef with Leola. Is that what you're saying, or you're saying Leola has beef?
And who was that talking about? Mariah in the comments said she bleach her skin in the morning routine.
What is the issue? Why y'all coming up with Mariah? Why y'all doing this? Who said that? Let me find you.
Well, I got to scroll back up in the comments. Hold on.
Y'all tap the screen, baby.
I get the with no money spirit. I got your beam on, put on the mirror. First young nigga.
Hey, Nikki.
BET Live. Come up, BET Live. I just see you come in the room, baby. Come up. BT Live, how you doing?
What's up, Bob?
I called you up because I need you to do me a favor.
What's that?
Teddy Hoes to get active.
Activate, goddammit. Activate.
I listened to you, just see you say that shit. I kid you not. I swear to God.
That shit trending, ain't it?
Mm-hmm. I fucks with that shit. Activate, goddamn it, activate.
Yes, sir.
I called you up here just for that motherfucking shit. I ain't gonna lie to you. I ain't gonna use sugarcoat shit. That's what the fuck I did. And I want to tell the motherfuckers to activate.
Yes, sir. I'm just not stepping in here. What y'all got going on?
We was talking about a whole bunch of stuff, including sending our condolences to Blue Dove. I see you got dropped out of the panel today.
Man, ain't that some bullshit, man?
Not really, because you know when people don't fuck with somebody, they don't fuck with somebody. You understand what I'm saying? And
yeah, but if the host fuck with it, if the host fuck with that person, though, why the moderator gotta be like that though?
The host don't fuck with her though. That's what they was trying to tell you. Just missed that.
No, I'm talking about me. I ain't talking about her. I was talking about me. I ain't coming there for her. I come for me.
Oh, but now I was in the comments, right? Listening, I just think, you know, comment. But you gotta read between the lines. Nobody fuck like because you came on a piece of shit. They don't want peace. They want the pink wig cut off. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We don't fuck with the hoe over here either.
Well, I understand that, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, you just can't loop everybody together, though. You know what I'm talking about? You can't, you know, and like I said, I'll be everywhere. I ain't got no picks and chooses, you know what I'm saying? If I'm going to activate, goddamn, I don't give a fuck where I'm at.
I'm glad you said that, Unc. What's up?
What up, Nee?
Oh, I thought you was acting funny because I was talking about your girl the other day. I didn't know. I'm like,
you know how me and you rock now. You know how me and you rock.
I know, but I asked you the other day and you ignored me. I'm like, well, damn, is he mad or something? What's going on?
I didn't see it. I'm sorry.
No, I didn't see it out loud. And I'm like, well, damn, Unc, all right, cool.
I didn't see it. I'm sorry. I didn't see it.
Oh, you good. You good.
You know, I fuck with you.
You can't get what I was gonna say to you. Don't take too much of that personal because the bitch did a lot of shit. I know you want you mean well, you want peace. The minute that bitch put them two strips of pink in her head, that bitch been starring extra shit. I ain't bullshitting though. Right now. I'm being real as I can. The bitch ain't gonna be shit. The bitch ain't never gonna be shit. I ain't like the bitch when I seen the bitch went feed her daughter. That was a problem for me.
Yeah. Well, you know, like I said, I'm just being me. I ain't picking no sides. No, you know, I can't, like you said, some people you just can't, you can't tell them what they're going to be themselves. You know what I'm saying? If, you know, that's just like me trying to tell you to stop going off on motherfuckers. You ain't going to stop that when they piss you off.
I don't go off as much as you think, you know. I fix a lot of problems. You
real patient. You real patient before you go off. Now, I give you that much. Mm-hmm. They strike that goddamn nerve and you had one too many. Goddamn activated.
You better know what you talk about when you said one too many, motherfucker. That means the lick ain't working no more. Oh, I done calm myself the best I can.
You goddamn right. Think I don't hear you. I know.
I ain't never lie about it either. I embrace my shit.
Okay.
Shit, I'm drinking this motherfucker now.
Okay.
But I know I'm going to light a bitch up tonight if they come incorrect. Because I feel it. I know it. That's why I'm on my backup. But at least I'm honest. I ain't got to lie. You know, I ain't lying about it.
Right. No, yeah, you ain't lying about it.
Mm-mm, that's why I told you, come tell these hoes get active.
So who tussling? Who tussling tonight? I know it's got to be. I know I'm late.
I don't know because it's a lot of bitches want pressure. You know, you got Miss Nature, old retired quarterback body ass, got a lot of shit to say. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of hoes out here.
Yeah.
You know, I try to stay in my lane because I don't run track no more. But every time I turn around, a bitch making a new track field and they asking me to run. And I'm like, no, babe, I'm sitting to the side because I didn't smoke. I'm tired. I've been drinking. But then they keep talking. So the drinks say, bitch, catch up. And I catch the fuck up and they don't like it.
Well, yeah. I like I said, you're a real one. I'm going to give you that, but you're a real one.
I mean, I don't know what else to say. Shit. I'm just telling these hoes, pass the baton. Where's the problem?
I don't think these hoes got no smoke.
No, not tonight. They don't because they know it's like, normally I am calm, but I will go there with you. I don't give a fuck about you and who made you. But the point is, you know, y'all, I hate that subliminal ass shit. I think the little ugly bitch wants to see me off, but I don't know why, because I don't even know who that ankle biting bitch is.
Now who is that?
I had muted the bitch, the ankle by the bitch that was saying about the what about when we was, you know, sending out condolences, the blue dove, the bitch talking about what about y'all making obituaries for people that still living. Like, you know, and no disrespect to nobody else in the comments, you know I fuck with y'all down in the comments. But I call her ankle biter because, bitch, you are in the comments. Bitch, you biting at my ankle with some shit you don't know about. Put your ass up. But where's the law?
So who is Blue Dove? I don't think I know her.
Blue Dog was a nice, sweet older lady that was on here. You do know she was on everybody panel. She was out and about. She was out, and you probably crossed paths with her. She's very sweet, very, very sweet. You guys probably didn't know her like that because she didn't argue a lot. She wasn't about arguing. Don't take offense, y'all, down there now. Shit, now. I told y'all I'm on one now. Don't take offense, but I have to say what I have to say, and I don't want y'all to take offense, because sometimes the shit that come out my mouth ain't always my goddamn fault. But she was an ankle biter.
Who farted? Who farted? Huh?
Oh, my gosh.
Is it? I don't know. Well, fuck it. I don't know. Just blame it on the liquor. I don't know. The fuck? I don't know. I guess, I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. I ain't drunk, but I am a little tipsy. Ever since I've been hearing about Blue Dove and the bullshit going on, I've been having a little smoke. Fresh in my heart. I ain't gonna even lie. And then, I've been feeling some type of way. You know, I'm woman enough to admit that I've been feeling some type of way. And I've been feeling some type of way because they disrespecting her, you know. But am I gonna blame it on you bitches that come at me tonight? Yes, I'm gonna take it out on you, and I'm gonna wake up, feel better tomorrow, but still think about her in our back end conversations, yes. So it's up to you, bitch, if you want to step in the paint. So if you got pressure with Bar tonight, it's the night. I may be lenient, I may not. You know, I don't know. I don't know. The Lord designed this day. So whether I go the right way or the wrong way, I can't tell you. You got to ask the Lord. Only he knew, because he knew this day was coming.
He knew the devil was gonna send him your way.
The BET, BET is here to tell any bitch with pressure.
Alexa, volume 3. Yeah, tap the screen.
Oh,
got you.
What's going on, Nikki? What's going on, baby?
Nikki, you back in the States?
Yeah, I'm back, y'all. I'm back.
Oh, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the safe return, honey.
Yes, welcome back, baby. Did you enjoy yourself?
Yes, I did. I enjoyed myself, shit, until I came back to the States. I was pissed.
Can you tell mama to take me next time? I got my passport and all that shit.
I got you. Take me next time.
Shit, I ain't gonna say shit, spit a spaghetti. I even just lay drunk in the room. I just went out.
You a mess. I got you though. I got y'all. I got you.
But man, y'all went up there. Y'all did it big though. You did a good job. Y'all did it big, baby.
Yeah, shit, my ass finna go back shit soon.
Y'all finna, both of y'all are just you.
More than likely both of us, because her ass always want to tag along.
Oh, well, you tell a bitch broke and I would like to go.
Yeah, I got you. I got you. Man, but yesterday I was so mad because my ass couldn't come up or whatever and say shit because I was on a damn flight.
That's what I want to ask. Good thing you said by yesterday. Thank you. Thank you, Nikki. BET. BET, you here? You on your other phone?
Go ahead, Barb.
How you feel about the inbox, the DM?
Oh, I don't fuck with no DM.
But no, but how, when I say how do you feel about, how do you feel about how the Omar and Mariah situation played out, like he calling her out, like, oh, she be in my DM, and then when it all boils down, it was actually him who reached out to her. She did not reach out to him.
Well, you know, people put on a facade on this goddamn app. They ain't being real, you know. You just can't be gullible what a motherfucker say on this app. They ain't representing themselves. I'm gonna say they ain't being their real self. They got representative. Right. So they say one thing and do another, you know?
Yeah.
I wouldn't put it past nothing.
Yeah, and another thing, in Mariah defense, she was like, well, I only answer back to him because I shake your hand. You know how you shake your hand? She said, I don't even reach back to him because, you know, shake your hand because my thing ain't, my video ain't on, so you don't see my hands shaking. So you know what that means when you play. She thought he played a tambourine, basically.
Oh, thought he was alphabet.
Huh?
She thought he was alphabet.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Oh, hey. So that was the only one she responded to.
I don't know. Wait a minute, sir. He wanted to run back to his homies and say joy for me. You know what? That is a good motherfucking one that I've seen. He wanted to run back to his homie and say George Foreman's daughter was in his DM. That has fucking shit I've seen.
The accuracy in that comment.
Mm-hmm. That has been good. That is very good. And that's why I say a lot. See, a lot of people think I'm still not settled because he said he was gonna take this platform, so I ain't rest yet. But anywho, needless to say, that's neither here or there because I ain't never worried, and y'all know that.
So I wanted to speak to that comment about that opinion or that theory. Wouldn't that be a little bit worse than for him if that was the case? He was talking to her for that reason. Wouldn't that be worse than him actually just flirting with her? Because then at that point, he said all these things about how she's not this, he don't like her because of that. But if that theory is true, then you put all that aside and the way you say that you feel just to be able to tie yourself to her, it considered clout chasing.
Somebody just made a good point. Saying everybody saying that's George Foreman's daughter but her. Has she said it yet? She admitted?
I mean, everybody know that. So you could Google her and see that that's her. You know what I mean? It's no, like, there's no faking the phone. You know what I mean? We know.
Yeah, but
she wants to have her own identity. And I guess it. Nobody wants to be known as that's George Foreman. That's why a lot of the celebrities keep their kids out of the spotlight to have their own identity. Like, who wants to be continued to be thrown in the face in the shadows of their appearance? Bitch, like me, I wouldn't want to be thrown. Bitch, I got my own life, motherfucker. I could get fucked up. I could cuss you. I could do all kind of shit. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, but that could open doors for you too, also.
But her doors, in probably real life, but on TikTok, you don't need to.
Already open for her. Is you get what I'm saying? Who? But you got to understand her perspective. why do I constantly have to be in the shadows of my parents? Because when something goes wrong, you blame me and my parents, you throw it up in my face. If something goes good, you blame me and my parents, you throw it up in my face. So I win either way. Get to know me. You already know. You know about my parents because they live a public life, right? Get to know me for who I am. And I think that's more than fair. She should not have to live under the shadows of a parent. Now, if she wants to, that's fine. But I don't think that she has to do that. I think that she deserves a right to have her own individual self being brought forth. You know, and you might not like it, and that's okay. Somebody else do. You understand where I'm going with that?
Yeah, I feel you.
Barb, I have to agree. I do have to agree because I know it's like we joke and all that stuff like that. But when people really want to attack her, they be like bringing up her father and stuff. That's why last time I had dropped that girl, Bree, whatever her name was. Because she was going in, bringing up her father and stuff. And I was like, attack her. Go in on her. You bringing up her father as a dig, and the girl don't even be bringing up her father and stuff. We all do because we know the connection. But that's why I dropped her ass, because she was going left because she wasn't, she was sounding irrational off the rip. And it was like, what is your real beef? And then automatically she went with her father just attacking her. And I was like, that's why I dropped both of them out of, like, you ain't finna just attack her out of the blue and stuff, and you can't get no other substance other than, you know, oh, her father. And that's why I was irritated yesterday, because my ass was on a goddamn plane, and I couldn't say what the fuck I wanted to say, because what I really wanted to say was, you bitches literally was in the comments on my mods, was in the motherfucking comments talking about, it's the past. Every time, for the past couple of weeks, it's the past. And I noticed something too. When poor little rich girl and that girl Shay was on the panel, they wasn't dropped. But before they was getting dropped, they was getting reported. I was getting reported when we was discussing the shit. And so I felt it hilarious that they wasn't doing it at the time. So it made me go, you bitches was reporting motherfuckers. All I'm just saying about what happened, Trish fighting with Omar and Mariah, was the man was married. It don't matter who in the fuck or whatever like that is, whether the Mariah was married, whatever the fuck, he was married. Yo King was the one who played it off and tried to make it seem like Mariah was the one who Dean and him was thirsting and lusting after his ass. And you bitches literally went into her life and try to come up with this little story that, oh, you just dropped in there just by, you know, by the grace of God. Nah, y'all bitches went in there to start some shit. Like, that's all it was. Just stand on your shit. Like, come on. Nobody's fucking stupid. Y'all was fucking wrong. Y'all want to stand on his ass.
So, Nikki. Mm-hmm. So, Nikki. Did we ever find out who put the message out first?
He did. He did.
Omar did.
He said that he told them.
But there's always a but of this son of a bitch. He cut out some messages. Thank God Mariah didn't. So all the messages that he put out, we would think it was reading between the lines, right? But when she put out her message, you got to see that. Oh, this was missing. Make sense?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the thing is that the man is married. I think that's what, you know, I was looking as much as I could before my flight or whatever. Wi-Fi got out because I was pissed. But I was just like, y'all motherfuckers is really gonna stand on here, attack the girl. I don't give a fuck. Look, Leola's a troll. I always say that and stuff and whatnot. But the thing is right is wrong is wrong. Y'all motherfuckers literally went into her lab to attack her ass over your fucking God, your king. Because y'all so fucking obsessed, because that's what the fuck is giving. And y'all know you bitches is wrong, and I don't give a fuck, because y'all know y'all was wrong. The man is married. You should be questioning his ass. while he's in.
You ain't gonna question him if you laying down with him too.
Another woman's DM, because I was like, y'all is too obsessive over this nigga. I'm sorry, it is what it is. Because
I gotta partially disagree. I don't think they're obsessed. I think they're young, and they think that they have a mature man hipping them to game. That's how I look at it. And they're being misled. That's my opinion. No.
I'm saying, in my opinion, I'm gonna have to disagree with that, because there's not even just women. There is people 40, 50 years old acting like them. And when I mean standing for motherfuckers.
Who is this mom that came and was doing all the craziness that's 50 years old?
No, I'm not saying, I'm saying about the behavior, because I think the reason why I disagree with it is because of the age thing. Age don't matter in certain situations, because that behavior is gone, especially from what I've personally seen on TikTok, it goes across the board. And it's the obsession of how some mods and how some people act, not even just mods, how some people act towards their favorite creator, whether they as 20, 30, 40, hell, some of these motherfuckers be 70 years old going the fuck in. And I'd be like, Lord Jesus, calm the fuck down. The person who you following is wrong in this situation. They're wrong. You can defend them and stuff like that on other situations, but when they're clearly in the wrong, clock that shit. But they don't do it. So that's why I said the whole age thing, these bitches is grown, got kids. Okay. Like, I'm just saying that
some kids, but not there yet.
But I get what you're saying. But I'm just saying that I feel like that when we say those things, it kind of gives the thing to like, oh, you know, they don't know what they're doing.
Where Kales go?
My bad.
I was just saying that, like, I totally understand where you're coming from and stuff. Like, I do. But on this one, they've been doing it for a while. And I understand give a person some grace. Like, oh, you know, they young and stuff like that after one time. They've been doing this shit constantly. Constantly, Barb. They know what the fuck they doing.
Yeah, I won't say they don't know what they're doing. But mm-hmm. What I'm saying is, like, they're under a man who they respect, right? And clearly it's other shit, you know, because by the voice recordings we heard, you know, a lot of other shit goes on, you know, talking. Like, it was just weird to me, you know, because to kind of find out he was married doing that, so I don't know where to go with this, because I'm not trying to destroy his marriage. And but anywho,
no, I get what you're saying. You're saying that because they're young and how he is, they're more prone to be gullible about his bullshit and not clock it as they should. Yeah. I totally understand it, because I've seen that too. I was just saying from my perspective, I get that in the beginning of things when that happens. And I understand, you know, about the guy, you know, how these men, or just in general, how some creators can, you know, really disrupt people's minds, especially when they're younger, and guide them in the wrong. It's just the way that it's constantly being shown that he, you know, in this situation in particular, that he is wrong, and that they tried to flip it. It was like he made it, try to make it seem like Mariah was the one who DM'd him first, and he was like, she was stalking him in a sense and trying to go after him, a married man, all this stuff, and yada, yada, yada. But it flipped, and it was like, oh, your Lord and Savior is the one who was doing all this shit. So where's smoke for him? And it's like they backtracking and shit. It's like, no, come on, let's be fucking for real. He wrong. One
of the young ladies did say they did get at him about it. She did say that. It was one of them that did say that now.
Mm-hmm.
She did say that, but I don't know how much weight they could carry, because he's a fast talker. You know, yeah. Y'all know how fast talkers are. And I don't care for someone who don't know how to stick to a subject and bring a lot of people in, you know. Yeah. It was just the topic kept switching when the main topic was what was the purpose of telling your mods that she be in your DM, right? It was, oh, motherfucker, you did this. Oh, fuck her, she ain't my type. I couldn't understand that. That didn't give me purpose.
That goes back to the topic yesterday. Do men take rejection well? Clearly, he didn't.
I'm gonna say shit because I'm a grown ass woman. You know,
I'm gonna say that. Married man ain't got no business fucking around on TikTok trying to hit on these women in the damn DMs. And you know, shit like that. Now he dead ass wrong for not having respect for himself and his wife. You know, supposed to tell him when they come to him. You know, I'm married. I don't do that. You know,
who heard what they wanted to hear? Hold on, I ain't mean to cut you off, BZ Live, okay. But who heard what they wanted to hear, and who checked them? Cause we didn't see y'all checking.
Wait, what?
Smoothie, see, that's why I muted your ass last time with your crybaby ass.
Hold on. Let me read it.
She said she's 32.
Hold on. I'm 32, and he was chic. I just think at this point, y'all hear what y'all... No, Smoothie, I think you hear what you want to hear because you're not getting the point, my love. And this is why we're having this conversation right now, because 32 is still a loss. You know what I mean? In sort of a sense. Like... You got a married man, right, telling you that we don't have to check him in front of y'all. We didn't ask you to, my love. Smoothie, wrong page, baby. You want to come up? You want to come up?
This the whole thing about it.
Would you like to come up, Smoothie?
You must be one of his mods.
She is. She is.
And that's fine. You know, we can have a conversation because I don't think she gets the gist of what we're saying.
She was here yesterday, wasn't she?
Yeah.
Yeah. But Bob, didn't you just say that one of them had already said that they checked him about it?
Yeah, it was actually her who said.
Yeah, so I'm not understanding why. I don't know.
My thing is, if you saying you checked them, cool, fine. But the other little subtle shit, whatever, it's like, shut the fuck up about it.
Nobody asks you that. See, that's what other shit comes along, and, you know, it is what it is. I've never asked you to check him in front of me. I don't need that. Y'all, like, clearly y'all have back-end conversations. You know what I mean? I'm not asking for that. What I'm saying is, and I'm going to stick by what I'm saying, he's a grown-ass manipulating man that's manipulating y'all mind, and y'all believe the bullshit that he's saying. And I'm going to stick to what I'm saying. I'm saying this. No one on this panel is saying this but the bar.
And
it's realistic though. You know what I mean? I've never respected no man. I never respected no man who comes after a woman that's not coming after them. If he was okay with her DM him and be like, hey, your mom's dropped me, I don't see where the smoke come. Like, it's so much to me. It's hidden. This shit like Hidden Figures. If he went to y'all and be like, hey, why y'all block Mariah, this and that, you having a back-end conversations, doing y'all thing, talking, hey, I blocked her because of this, that, and that. Where in the design was fit for him to say, by the way, she be in my DM?
Wait, I'm sorry. Somebody said y'all cut Omar off when he was trying to bring up Mariah's past, but talked about his mom drama, which had... What is y'all not getting? He is a married motherfucking man in somebody's DM. Can y'all understand it? I don't give a fuck about nobody's past. They could worship the devil for all the fuck I care. What is y'all not understanding about this whole concept? The man is married. He talk about his wife, and I'm going to say it. He talk about his wife, my wife, my wife, my wife. Same things like these women. My husband, my husband, my husband, my husband. Look at the... Our motherfucking...
This is the thing. Bitches.
Wait, hold on, Bar. Hold on, Bar, because I'm going to say... Because with Peter, for instance, his wife, oh, my husband, whole time she lusting after another motherfucker. My thing is that these people be on these apps or whatever like that, talking about my husband, my wife, my this, my that,
And then when you find out that these motherfuckers ain't that goddamn loyal, all of a sudden, well, what about that person's past? Well, no, bitch, let's focus about what the fuck is being said now. They're married. One minute y'all motherfuckers like picking and choosing. One minute y'all have these moral codes about, oh my God, these sad hoes and all this and everything like that.
Activate, goddammit. Activate.
But then one minute when y'all faves or whatever like that come and do the wrong, now all of a sudden, oh well, Mariah's passed. I don't give a fuck right now. We talking about the fact why this married man is in somebody's motherfucking DMs. Clock that shit.
Deflection.
Like, it really is deflection. I don't give a fuck what no one says. It is deflection. Why the fuck is a married man and any woman's fucking DM but his fucking wife? Like, what the fuck is y'all not getting?
And let me piggyback off that. Why, hold on, because before I forget, Princess, why is a married man right on here saying he has options? Why nobody speaking on when he said he has options? The only motherfucking option should be for you is your wife. You could get bitches that look better than Mariah, hair better. What the fuck do you mean by that shit? Come on, y'all. Let's not let the little shit pass us. Why are there options? There should be no option. Your only option should be your wife. Or did I go somewhere I ain't got no business?
You preaching. That's it right there. You stay right there.
I mean, I'm just trying to figure that out. I mean, I've not heard nobody like really touch on that. Why is not the wife the first option and the only motherfucking option? No matter the trials and the tribulations, we all go through shit. Well, you know.
Hold on. Give me a second. Hold on. Let me address something real quick. So, Coco Marie 2.0, baby, your comment, you said,
Peach, y'all blocked them.
Bias. Can y'all hear me? Hold on. Wait. Let me say this. Y'all bias. This whole platform is biased. Peach, they training your platform. God just humbled you. And I'm still humble. I'm still humble. Right is right, wrong is wrong. Even though everybody's moral compass is not the same, it's just with me, I have boundaries. Some people don't. I'm just saying.
Queen, I just want to say, you know, I blocked them.
Wait. Weird that y'all tagging Peach, but I'm doing all the motherfucking talking. Why are you tagging Peach? Why are you what come, like, what the Peach, that motherfucking shit. You hoes tagging Peach, but I'm doing the motherfucking talking. I'm a grown ass woman. I speak for me. I don't speak for Peach. I say what I felt, and I felt what I said. I ain't even said it all.
Here we go. Activate, goddammit. Activate.
Oh, real quick.
I mean, because that's what they asking for. I said it.
Real quick, if y'all can't see the box lighting up, y'all may have to log out of TikTok or that.
They ain't gotta see the box. They know the difference between our voices.
Yeah, no, I was just saying in general. I know, I'm just saying in general, because before that comment, a whole bunch of people said that. So just do that shit, you know, just FYI.
They know we don't sound the same.
Yeah, I don't.
Hey, y'all.
And hold on. What the fuck y'all thought? I was finna be nice to him? After he said he was gonna go live and come for a bitch on this panel? You can't come for nobody. The only thing you can do, baby, is meet me at a drag show. What are we doing?
They gonna fight for him.
But guess what? That's fine. They can fight for him. And I'm gonna speak on what is right. I give no fucks about what they feel.
What they trying to do is silence y'all and not talk about
silence who? You can't silence. You see how big my mouth is?
I know.
You
can't silence that's what they trying to do.
You, but that's
coming out the peach.
That's unrealistic on the app. That a whole grown man pretending to be who the fuck he say he be. Because any nigga who connected like that with anybody who could touch somebody would not speak of it. So I've been read through them lines.
Wait, Barb. Some Proxy said something. Proxy said his wife was shown, and I think that's what he means by nothing is off limits. But here's the thing. When the picture was shown, Peach said, you know, nah, we ain't gonna do that and stuff, and you know, out of respect for his wife. So I think that's the thing that people don't be clocking is, you know, I think it was poor little rich girl who had it in her backdrop or whatever like that. Mm-hmm. And the thing is that, you know, she did it, she come took it down, and it was out of respect or whatever, and this is Peach Live. So if he gonna go and say, oh, I'm gonna come after Peach or Barb or whoever, other than, and I'm just saying, not to put too much onto you, poor rich girl, but I'm just saying, other than the person, it just shows you his character that, oh, he's been wanting to do it and it's smoke for whatever, because
it can be smoke. You know what? It don't even worry about explaining that shit. It could be smoke. What he didn't count on,
like I said, the only reason what he didn't count on
is Peach got a motherfucking squad. Mm-hmm. The fuck he thought? My best friend is a gay man. Bitch, you want a paddleboard or what, toe? Now, what you best bet is to do is stay where you at and don't.
Hold on, wait. Hold on, Bar. Proxy said she did, but that was after it was shown prior to that without correction. Peach corrected it afterwards. That is true.
And I said the only reason I put it up there was because he was talking so bad with his time.
Because my thing is, everybody know how this page goes. It, people bring up receipts and all kind of shit all the time. It's funny when it's you got the issue, but when it was somebody else, you did not care. You was hooping and hollering and couldn't wait to be on this panel, especially when it was somebody you was against. You jump on here and say your tag, but when it's your turn, it's a problem. We all gonna have a turn, including me. But guess what, you bitches, you ain't gonna faze me, bitch.
Well, they say you bitches ain't fucking with me.
But the thing is
Peach, what was the threat? Hold on
1 second, BET. Peach wasn't, if he remembers yesterday, Peach wasn't even in the camera. So that means that if her face is not right here, guess what she's doing? She's not sitting at the computer. She's not sitting at her phone. She's in the back, walking around, taking care of her kids. Whatever it is that she's doing, using the restroom. So she didn't even see the picture when it was posted the first time.
But why does that matter? This is a recap page. If they're giving us recap of content that happened before, whatever happened before, they showing us it was messages under it. I don't understand when that became a problem. I'm just saying, I'm just tired of having to explain for a recap motherfucker page. But when you bitches do it, it ain't no motherfucking problem. When you bitches go to blow the belt on somebody, it ain't no motherfucking problem. So why is it a problem over here? Our motherfucking way. Not long.
And Bobby,
not long.
You just said, like he was talking about, like, I can. You know, he was talking about Mariah looks. I can get this woman. I mess with none but high value women. My wife this, my wife that. You know, so since he said he got a type, I was showing his type. This is his type.
But it was a valid fucking point. You said you get the baddest bitches, right?
That's why I showed it.
You was putting Mariah down. Like, I'm trying. It baffles me when people pick and choose what they want to be involved in. It baffles the fuck out of me.
They think they off limits. That's why.
No. Unless that he think and they think his wife is unattractive. So is that why his wife couldn't be up? Because if I had a bad bitch, I'd be like, keep her. Hell no, don't take her down.
But we never said she wasn't unattractive. We said she was a beautiful woman. But I was just showing his type.
Obviously, he don't feel the same because her picture was up. The only reason why he don't feel, like, and one thing I heard him say, I'm an open book. I go by my real name. So people know who I am. So if people know who you are and who you am, they're going to know who your kids are, who your wife is, right? Makes sense? So what was the problem with your wife being up? Because I thought she was beautiful. I really did. But obviously you don't feel the same because you felt some type of way by her being up. Come on, y'all. Don't play stupid with me.
Or you'll be like, look at my wife. That's a flex. Look
so you don't feel the motherfucking same.
Exactly.
One thing I do is call a spade and a heart a heart and a diamond, bitch. We playing spades of trump. What we doing, motherfucker? What you thought was this was a weak ass motherfucker pimp. But no, it ain't, motherfucker. It ain't at that. When you made that statement, you gonna go live. I ain't see you go live yet. And when you come for me, motherfucker, you better come motherfucking correct. Correct. And I meant that. And if you do decide to send your mods over, you better send them motherfucking correct. And I'm
not getting
this woman. I know how to have a motherfucking conversation, but I know how to slaughter hoes and niggas too at the same motherfucking time.
Bob, I'm not understanding. I'm not understanding. I know they told me about the threat, but which platform he talking about dragging?
This platform, because what happened was when he entered the room, I believe he was in the room the whole time. When he entered the room at that time, his wife was on the panel. But you said out your mouth, you can get a lot of bad, but you can get this, you can get that, right? So why not have your baddest bitch on the screen, which is your wife?
If you felt that way about your wife.
That part. So what I mean, if you felt like your wife being on this platform as a picture was a problem, nigga, you feel like in your heart that she's not bad. You anybody feel where I come from? I'm gonna lose you. Losing y'all.
I'm right there with you.
I'm here. Like, it's your, it's your wedding day. Keep so your wife gonna look her best on her wedding day, right? So that's the best picture.
I probably disagree with that. You get what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, my thing was, you the one said you can get any bitch you can, any bad bitch at that. It you got options. Mm-hmm. When he said that, I took it as his wife could pull off different looks because we all look different as women when we do our hair different. Am I correct, women?
Mm-hmm. Different colors is a different woman.
But to know that you was talking about actual different women baffles the fuck out of me. And then you said, I have not rested on it. Because then you said, okay, it's open now. I come for come. I'm not a little girl. No. When you threaten to come for a platform, make sure the fuck you know what you doing. Make sure you know what you doing. And make sure the barb don't got popcorns in her pocket, motherfucker.
And Barb.
Don't think that motherfuckers ain't reaching out to the barb. Don't just know that. They ready to spill your tea. But like I say, I pay check, not checkers, motherfucker. Don't play with me.
And I just want to say something. Wait, oh, my baby.
I'm cooking right now. I'm cooking so y'all can eat. Then the motherfucker come on here and say, and drop bar. Drop who? Your lip? Because I mean.
Drop who? That's what I told you. Yeah, nah, I ain't dropping Barb. What's up?
Drop who?
Dropping Barb.
Your tuck belt? Not me. The fuck you mean? I can assure you. You can fuck with anybody you want to, but stay away from this area here. I got me, motherfucker. I got me. And I've been in this gay life so motherfucking long. So long. If anybody ever graced the presence of your ass, motherfucker, I would know. So tread lightly with me, motherfucker. You don't know who I know. That's the problem, stupid motherfuckers. That's the fucking problem. And it's been motherfucking proven. I don't gotta prove it tonight for nobody. Cause I can easily get the fuck on the phone and send a picture to my cousin and be like, you know this fish? Cause that's what the fuck I would call you. You know this fish? Cause it gives bottom. It gives bottom. It gives very much bottom. Don't come for me when I've not sent for you. Now, what I did do was try to have a conversation, but you was throwing shots. Tread motherfucking lightly. Tread motherfucking lightly. Girl. You got problems?
I don't think you do. I'm tryna fuck a nigga lungs up. They be like, nah, don't put them damn guns up. Fuck that. Say big brother bring on guns out. When it smoke, we get the spin while the sun out. I ain't never looking. I pump gas with my gun out. Scream out what's happening and get the bus until it run out. All these niggas.
Y'all tap the screen. We should be at 100K by now. Come on, man. I don't want to have to put it on sub only. Can y'all please help me reach my live goal? I need 9 more galaxies. Let's go, man. It's Tulsa Tuesdays. Why do people feel like they want to fuck with me, man? Fuck with me and my people. You feel me? Come on, man. It ain't even that serious, cuz.
You can see your best man, you gon' lose your best hitter.
Come on, baby, who wants smoke?
What the fuck is that? That's how I step on niggas. Nah, I step on these bitches.
Man, what do you want, bitch?
When he be ready for the bottom.
Who the fuck is that? Bro, go check the door, look out the window, don't forget the strap. I be on their ass when I see ops, I do forget I got. I be on this shit wherever I'm at, I learned that from the rap. He gon' drink whatever nigga sell him just to say we have. They be like he wasn't even with that shit. Whenever nigga die, mercy won't always lie to y'all. Whenever nigga die, set a nigga stable as they check.
Tap the screen, baby. 100K goal, let's go.
Stump his ass. Better do what Nardo said, cause niggas die for public gas.
Thank you, Boosie. Y'all go ahead and hit that 1 cent heart me for me, please.
Creep up out that cut, we like not a voice. Catch before you run that gun on. Hey, who you kill? They ain't talking like you get a drill. We gon' kill you sober, who done told you that I need a pill?
Where I dare step or put my toe on that boy.
Come on, baby! Don't fuck with me, man. Stop playing, man. Stop playing with me.
Get shot in your shit. Oh, niggas.
Really trying to be nice for real, man. Chill.
Leaving bingo with this bitch. And we sent a blitz. Nardo trying to fight me by the stick. Is this turn of blitz? I can't even run.
If y'all fucking with the peach, man, drop the peaches in the chat, man. Drop the peaches in the chat, baby. If you fucking with peach, drop the peaches in the chat, man.
13, 14, 15, 16. Hollow till they hit his face. What the fuck is that? What the fuck is that? Hit that little bitch front or back.
Pest Carl, who caught by rats?
Won't smoke with us, nigga. I been a real killer. I'm a rapping street nigga. Copy paste the lead niggas. Can't wait till we see niggas. Who won't smoke is free. All the oppa sweet switch. Hop out middle of the street. Hit him. Soon as he fall off his feet. Kill him. Been out all week.
If you fucking with the bar, man, drop the pink hearts in the chat. Let's go.
Shout out a week, bitch. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fuck the awesome niggas hoes. 5, 6, 7, 8. Slam the race with GDK. 9, 10, 11, 12. No man still ain't go to jail. 100K checks in the mail. Put that away just for bill.
Which pink car?
Auntie house still got the smell. Fans be negative as hell. Fuck that shit, I just prevail. Hey, y'all hold 100 shells. Aim that bitch, shoot everywhere.
It's the one on my work class. There's so many to choose from. Which one do I choose? Which one?
Not classy.
So many options. I just have so many options.
Oh, don't be missed because I'm on my winning.
There you go. I just want to know what type of the pink hearts you wanted in the chat.
There you go, right there, baby. Alexa,
ask what kind of peaches they want in the chat.
Pink hearts.
Okay, let me mute, because baby, I'm
she said with the pink hearts, Barb. It's okay. I'm asking which pink heart you want.
Classy, don't start.
I was being for real.
You was trying to be technical.
I really was. So many options.
Untechnical and for real.
Oh, Lord, Barb. Okay. I'm just pick one. God dang it.
Oh, yeah. I just wanted to point out something while, you know, because, you know, Barb was cooking, you know, I had to, you know, I did, you know, slide in, but, you know, Barb was cooking. But I just wanted to clock something. Now, Smoothie Ass was in the comments and stuff saying what she said, but she was having a little hit, you know, little dishes in it, right? Now, let that have been any of our asses over in Omar shit, we would have been blocked and muted so fucking quickly. So this is why I say the shit and do the shit that I do. Because when they asses is over here, they act all brand new and yada, 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 and want to do whatever the fuck they want to say whatever the fuck they want on the panel or in the fucking comments. But when you're in their spaces, oh, it's rules. It's this. No disrespect to the panel. No disrespect to the host or whatever like that. Bitch, get the fuck out of here with that fucking flip-flopping bullshit.
Baby, it's okay. She was down there fighting for her life in them comments. It's
we
okay.
Bigger than that, baby. We bigger than that. The difference is, over here, you get to say what you want to say back. They mute you and block you because they don't, y'all exchange comments, conversation in the comments, right? They don't get to come on the panel and say that. Over here, you get to air your grievances out, baby. So therefore, if you got a problem with that, you can address her here. This is an unbiased panel. Everybody welcome to tussle. Mods against mods, meaning other panel. However, y'all do it. That's why we don't block them. We mute them sometimes because they get a little annoying.